Oh, wow.
Jeg skal bare lige tænke mig om, hvordan jeg kan sige det.
Oh god.
I would describe College of Wizardry as being...
College of Wizardry er en magisk skole, som udspringer fra Harry Potter-verdenen.
It's very much like a high school. Like any high school Hollywood movie that you've seen, with the same kind of drama happening. Except that on top of that, you obviously have the magic.
You go there, and you are a witch for a weekend, and you go to classes, and you have some romance here and there, and you have some rivalry here and there.
They come to study magic, cast spells, and get in trouble.
It's a cool high school, but with magic, and so many feelings.
The problem with trying to explain LARP is that once you're in it, you don't see why people don't understand the concept anymore.
Min baggrund med rollespil er som så mange andres, at jeg var den lille spinkle nørd med langt hår, som måske ikke passede helt ind i fodboldklubben eller håndboldklubben. Og da der så åbnede sig en mulighed, der hed rollespil, så fandt jeg automatisk sammen med mange andre, ligesom mig selv.
This isn't even all of it, and it's already not fitting into the suitcase, so I don't know how I'm gonna bring everything.
It was actually a very boring flea market, and then I just spotted this one. It's like, this is mine.
You step into a completely different universe with desires and quests and problems that have nothing to do with your own. It's just super exciting. It's like traveling, except that this time you're traveling to something that's imaginary. And it's amazing.
Laughing is kind of like an emotional cleanse. Like some people do juice cleanses to get the toxic things out of their body. I do LARP to get some emotions out that have been stuck. Sometimes you feel like kind of numb from like everything that's going on, and then you go to a LARP and you cry and you laugh and you are angry and you shout, and then the weekend's over and you just feel like it's all gone out and now I can go back to reality like a fresh human. So this is the box. I like to collect my memorabilia in. Some of this might look like trash, but it's all very dear to my heart and it's very... It all holds memories, even this, which is just to hide my face from demons. Just like a lot of random stuff. Here's more letters, more name tags. It's so hard to say goodbye to the characters and all these things like tell the story again. So when I want to like think back on the times, I can just go through here and be like, oh my god, I forgot about this, and then kind of relive the story again.
Den her tryllestav passer til min rolle, som er en ung russisk mand, som er virkelig glad for Adidas. Sådan. Jeg tror, det er sundt at stikke lidt af fra hverdagen, fordi den er blevet så hektisk, og der er så mange ting, man skal, og der er så mange krav, og der er så meget stress. Og der er rollespil rigtig godt til, at man kommer lidt afsted, lidt ud hjemmefra, og så glemmer de her ting. Jeg oplever rigtig mange, som til hverdag ikke rigtig kan slappe af, men godt kan slappe af, når de er til rollespil.
welcome to College of Wizardry 21!
Lab is getting more mainstream nowadays, but lab still has to fight a stigma. I think it was in the 80s when everyone said we were just a cult praising Satan.
Det er typisk nørdede mennesker. Det er typisk dem, der sidder foran computeren hele dagen. Det er typisk folk, der har et problem af en eller anden slags. Og nogle af fordommene passer, og nogle af fordommene passer slet ikke.
Most people just think we're weirdos. We're a bunch of nerds who don't have any friends running through the woods screaming fireball in really ugly costumes. And they don't understand how much lab can do. And it's really sad because it means they are missing out, not just on the fun, but also on opportunities.
Alle de ting, der sker i løbet af weekenden, kan man godt blive ret medtaget, ret følelsesmæssigt. Der er højdepunkter, og der er ting, man glæder sig til og håber på, som er vildt spændende, og man lever så fuldstændig med ind i det. Og nogle af dem ender med en lykkelig slutning, nogle af dem ender med en meget ulykkelig slutning.
You're sitting in class next to me, talking, giggling, while you knew.
Der er mange følelser på spil hele tiden. Så har du det super godt og er virkelig, virkelig glad. Og så kan der ske et eller andet, hvor du bliver virkelig ked af det. Så det er lidt som en rutsjebane, der kører op og ned. Det sker tit i rollespillet, at der er nogle mennesker, som lever sig så meget ind i rollespillet og bruger så meget tid på det, at på en eller anden måde, så ender de med at drømme om den her verden. De drømmer, at de er deres rolle. Og uden det skal lyde alt for crazy, så er der også en gang imellem nogen, som så virkelig kommer til at savne deres rolle bagefter.
The lines absolutely blur. And sometimes I do wish I was my character, and sometimes I play my characters, and sometimes I feel like I am my characters.
You will actually forget who you are and who your character is. At least in my case, I very often find myself with something that's called bleed, where you don't know if the emotions that you're experiencing are your own or are your character's.
Bleed is incredibly hard to explain to people who have not experienced it. The thing people come closest to with is probably watching a movie and crying because it's sad. But then just imagine like being in the movie and like how much more intense that would be. And then you might have an idea of what bleed feels like.
Cronio Urio. Oh no. Okay. Smoke means there's gonna be a portal.
Who are you?
I'm Maple Chodorovsky Jones. Your great 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 granddaughter or something. I don't know how many grades really.
That's great.
Der er et kæmpe overlap efterfølgende fra sådan et arrangement her, hvor at man i kortere eller længere perioder virkelig ønsker sig, at man ikke var tilbage til sin kedelige grå hverdag. Men at man er en troldmand eller heks på et magisk slot.
It enables people to do a number of things that they weren't able to back in real life, back in the mundane world. And I've heard from a number of participants, many of them who had trouble with social interactions. Many of them on the autism spectrum, many of them who had social anxieties, that they were uneasy about going into this in the first place, but once they got here, they found that they were able to do things that they had not expected they would be able to. That this place, this event, this community, gives them an alibi, a mask, if you will, that means that their former insecurities, debilitating insecurities in some cases, just aren't as bad anymore.
Speak up, again.
3, 2, 1.
Very well.
Jeg vil helt klart sige, at jeg har brugt rollespillet som træning til at blive mere udadvendt.
Even the game mechanics are useful in real life. When you're playing a LARP and you want to touch somebody, just like a hand on a shoulder, or you want to hug them, for instance, or kiss them or have sex with them, you always need to ask for consent. And that is not something that a lot of people apply in normal life. And a lot of people would do very well to apply it in normal life.
When I play other characters, I get to kind of explore sides of myself that I would usually suppress because they're not accepted in society or I think they are not good traits. One of the characters I played in the past, I really amped up my like being in love with everyone and like being kind of annoying and just going forward and like talking to everyone no matter if they wanted to talk to me or not. And I amped up to the point where I was like, no one's gonna like this character, it's too much. And then she still had friends, and there were still people who loved her. So it kind of taught me that just because I have a few traits that might be annoying or a bit too much, doesn't mean people won't like me. And to be able to explore that in a way where I can be mean for a weekend and see what that feels like, and see how people react, and then I can go back to myself and take the lessons I've learned from that and incorporate it into being a better person. This community is so incredibly inclusive and kind. And yeah, you have, you know, the black sheep here and there, but as a community, I've never seen people so considerate of other people's identities, other people's struggles. It's just like people really care.
You meet so many new friends in-game that you have no idea what they do in real life. You don't even know their real name. But they've become your friends in the game, and you feel like you've known them since forever. And then the game stops, and you just go like, hi, my name is actually Lisa, not Catherine, and you know, I'm a graphic designer in real life.
We are dope, we are dope, we are dope, we are dope, yeah!
LARP can absolutely include people that feel more excluded in reality or in the normal world. I know that a lot of us are people struggling with mental illnesses. A lot of us are people who have been bullied in the past. Not all. There is a lot more acceptance for that. And there's a lot more kindness for people that don't fit the social norm because we understand what it feels like. And when you go dress up in a castle and wave with wands, you're not really in a position where you can be like, you're weird.
Det betyder ikke særlig meget, om du er barn, ung eller voksen. Om du er fra Østafrika, Sibirien eller Norge. Det er sådan set ligegyldigt, hvor du er fra. Fordi når du tager din rolle på dig, så er der alligevel ikke nogen, der bekymrer sig om, hvor du er fra, og hvad du kan, eller hvor dygtig du er til hverdag, eller hvad du lever af, eller ikke lever af. I rollespillets verden, der betyder den slags mindre. Og derfor er det nemmere at være på lige fod.
I've been struggling with mental illnesses, and I still am. I'm not saying lab cured it, but lab helped me with it so much. It helped me to deal with it. It gave me something to constantly be excited about, like a little bubble where I was comfortable in. I never felt excluded or in danger, even though I'm not in danger in most situations, but my brain tells me to. And at labs, I don't get that. I just feel confident at a lab, and I'm not constantly checking myself, how I look, what I say. I just lose all these insecurities that come with my anxiety. And it helps me with my depression so much. Like, it's just something to be happy about. And when I can't get out of bed, sometimes lab is the only thing that does get me out. And if that means that at 10 p.m., I put a bra on for the first time of the day so I can talk to my friends for half an hour because they have questions about our characters, then that's what it is. But at least I did get out of bed.
Activius! Well, we should keep an eye on the fire, though.
Sometimes I'm going to be so excited about a craft project that I get out at 8. And I go to the shops, which I don't do. I don't leave my house if I don't actually have to. So, lab makes me do that. That's incredible.
I think it has really like created this insane, incredible hobby for me, mostly. And I'm totally addicted to it now. Like every time there's a new LARP coming out with a universe that I, you know, that I like, then I just have to jump on it and get a ticket.
We love you. We love you.
One really big thing that has changed for me is just my friends. The people that I've met through LARP are so much more open-minded than the friends that I used to have. And it's even got to a point where I can talk with these people about things that I can't talk about with my former friends or family, because they wouldn't understand.
Jeg føler, at rollespil helt klart har været med til at danne den person, jeg er i dag.
You ended up being my mentor.
I love it.
Hvor at jeg ikke gør, som det passer mig, og jeg ser ud, som det passer mig. Og jeg er gladere for at være unik og være et unikt menneske. Og at jeg ikke rigtig bekymrer mig så meget om, at jeg skal være ligesom alle de andre. Eller jeg skal gøre som de andre, eller hvad der er normalt. Det har været med til at gøre, at jeg i dag tænker, at det er en dårlig ting at være normal. Og det er en god ting at være unik. Og man bliver et spændende menneske af at have spændende historier. Og bruge sin fantasi på alle mulige vinkler og kanter.
LARP has enriched my life with so many things. LARP has given me friends. LARP has given me newfound confidence. LARP has given me a new level of kindness, of understanding for other people. It has given me a creative outlet in so many different ways. It's given me memories that are absolutely priceless, that I would never swap for anything in the world. And it's given me memories to be made in the future as well. LARP has just changed my life completely in every aspect.